Welcome to the Sheraton in Eatontown, and this is the 2015 Shore Sports Zone All-Zone Team. It is a great night to celebrate high school football. I'm Rich Krampanis. We have the best of the best from the Shore Conference, and during our special, we will break down some great moments from the 2015 season and present our second Zoman Trophy in the Jersey Shore. It's time for us to get started as we meet the 2015 All-Zone offense.
Let's meet the All-Zone quarterbacks. Donald Glenn is a three-year starter for Middletown North, and his play in 2015 elevated him to be among the top quarterbacks at the Jersey Shore. Glenn engineered a Lions offense to 1,989 passing yards and 17 TD passes. The junior was able to throw a variety of passes, from sharp bullets on the slant to effectively throwing the deep ball. Red Bank Catholic's Eddie Hahn overcame a summer knee injury to be one of the Shore's top players in his senior season. Hahn threw for over 1,700 yards and 12 TDs. He was also a threat on the ground, racking up over 450 yards and four scores. Hahn finished fifth in our Zoneman Trophy balloting and is set to begin his college football career when he signs in February to play at the University of Connecticut. Noah Husak was the trigger man for one of the most improved teams in the Shore Conference. The Point Pleasant Borough quarterback helped the Panthers share the B-South title. Husak was a great running quarterback who ran for 813 yards and 13 touchdowns. He also threw four TD passes and helped his team to an outstanding 8-2 record in 2015. Toms River North quarterback Mike Husney is in rarefied air in New Jersey high school football as a 1,000-yard rusher and 1,000-yard passer. With two seasons under his belt as the Mariners QB, Husney has some pretty gaudy numbers: 5,628 combined yards passing and rushing, and a total of 54 touchdowns. Husney was a warrior in the South Jersey Group 5 final, scoring a touchdown and making some key runs in the Mariners' 14-7 win over Williamstown. Jack Nowitzki was the offensive general of the Red Bank Bucks. Nowitzki proved to be a great game manager and was able to showcase his talents both throwing the football as well as taking off on the ground. Nowitzki threw for 1,200 yards and ran for 520, accounting for 16 touchdowns. One of the team's leaders, Jack and his fellow senior teammates left a legacy as the Bucks went 11-1, claiming the B North Division crown. Michael O'Connor has been a two-year starter for Remsen Fairhaven, and the signal caller is a two-time state champion. O'Connor gives the RFH offense a dangerous dimension thanks to his ability to bust off huge runs as well as his big-time arm that allows Remsen to get vertical with big pass plays. O'Connor topped 1,000 yards on the ground and a total of 21 touchdowns, including 12 through the air. O'Connor is back under center next season for the Bulldogs as Remsen Fairhaven looks for its fourth straight state title. In Ocean, they call him Kenny Football, and Spartan signal caller Kenny Pickett has the talent and playmaking ability to have a great nickname. Pickett had a breakthrough junior season, finishing with just under 1,800 yards passing and an impressive TD to INT ratio of 19-4. Pickett already has a Division I offer from Temple University, and more will follow as he heads into his senior season with the Spartans. Tim Santiago was the main cog in the Brick Memorial rushing stampede. When the Mustang senior wasn't pitching the pigskin to Eli Laverin or Tony Thorpe, he was running roughshod every Friday night. His benchmark performance came on a 332-yard, four-touchdown game against Toms River North. Santiago topped the 100-yard mark 9 times and was the leading rusher in the Shore Conference among quarterbacks with 1,633 yards and 16 trips to the zone. Here are your all-zone running backs. Mike Bickford came out of nowhere in his sophomore year to become one of the Shore's leading rushers. In 2015, everyone knew about the Central Regional running back, and he delivered, despite being the focal point of defensive game plans. Bickford ran for 1,582 yards and made 21 trips to the end zone. With over 3,600 yards in the past two seasons, Bickford is back for one more season for the Golden Eagles. Derek Ernst was the fuel to the Raritan Rockets' improbable rise to a state title. everyone knew that the senior was getting the football, and he still couldn't be contained. Ernst finished 2015 with the short conference rushing title, 1,777 yards and 22 touchdowns. He closed out his high school career with another dominating performance, grinding out 144 yards and two TDs in the Rockets' 28-26 upset win over Lincoln to win the Central Jersey Group 2 crown. Mike Golic measures 5'9", but he plays so much bigger than his frame. The Jackson Memorial Junior has speed, but he is one of New Jersey's most physical runners, not afraid to get low and punish defenses who get in his way. As Jackson Memorial climbed from a number 7 seed to win a second straight sectional title, Golic was the catalyst, running for 578 yards and 7 touchdowns in the postseason. He was sensational in the finals at Rutgers, with 313 all-purpose yards in the Jaguars' 42-14 win over Brick Memorial. Asante Moore was a complete back for the Toms River North Mariners. We saw plenty of highlights of number one torching defenses with long runs. He was also reliable in short yardage situations. His 1 yard TD run in the state finals proved to be the game winner in getting the Mariners a South Jersey Group 5 title. His finest individual performance came as he racked up 281 all-purpose yards and 4 touchdowns in a win over Jackson Memorial. For the second straight year, Cole Rogers put up fantastic numbers, leading the Middletown South ground attack. What makes his 1,545 yards and 24 TDs even more impressive is the fact that Rogers missed 2 games due to injury. Rogers has the ability to let the play develop, find a hole, and pick up big chunks of yardage. He finished his high school career as a touchdown machine, scoring 2 or more TDs in each of his last 5 games. Marcus Salinas stepped in and led the Manalapan rushing attack in 2015. Salinas finished the year with 1,325 yards on the ground and 11 touchdowns. Marcus averaged over 6.5 yards every time he carried the rock for the Braves. Salinas got stronger as the season went on, gaining 181 yards in this win over Howell, and he followed that up with 159 yards in a playoff road win against Trenton. Amir Tyler is one of the top Division I prospects in New Jersey, and we've got the highlights to back it up. Tyler was a dominant runner, topping 1,000 yards on the ground and scoring 20 times. He was also a dominant force on the defensive side of the ball, with 103 tackles, 4 sacks, 4 forced fumbles, and 4 interceptions. Tyler was held in high regard throughout the short conference, finishing 4th in our Zoneman Trophy balloting. Ashante Worthy is one of 2 sophomores to earn all-zone honors. The Freehold Borough running back was more than comfortable in his second season of varsity football, running for over 1,300 yards and 9 rushing scores. Worthy averaged nearly 8 yards a carry and was a big reason that Freehold Borough scored quality wins over Manalapan and Middletown North. These are your all-zone wide receivers. Darian Carrington was the top target of Mike Husney at Toms River North, with 35 catches for 672 yards and 5 touchdowns, but the junior was equally impressive on the defensive side of the ball. In the South Jersey Group 5 finals, Carrington was a ball hawk, shutting down the Williamstown air attack and helping seal the championship with this interception in the final moments of the game. An excellent student, Carrington has already earned college credits and has 1 more year to play at Toms River North. Marquis Ellington was a playmaker for the St. John Vianney Lancers. It seems as if whenever Anthony Brown threw up a ball towards the end zone, Ellington was hauling it in. Ellington had 12 catches, and 9 of them went for touchdowns. The 6'6" senior averaged over 24 yards a catch. He also contributed on the Lancers' defense, recording a safety and 2 interceptions. Brendan Kuby was Donald Glenn's top target through the air at Middletown North, and he emerged as the leading receiver in the short conference for catches and receiving yards. Kuby racked up some incredible numbers, 61 catches, 1,046 yards, and 7 touchdowns. Coach Steve Bush has to be thrilled that the combination of Glenn and Kuby is back for the Lions for 1 more season. Kyle Johnson is one of the most versatile players on our all-zone football roster. Jackson Memorial took advantage of that versatility, switching Johnson from wideout to quarterback midway through the season. running the read option, Johnson gave the Jaguars offense a new and dangerous dimension, and it sparked the team to go on a special run as a number 7 seed to repeat as Central Jersey Group 4 champions. Johnson was also a dynamic playmaker on defense, and in the state finals, he showed off his skills at his original position with a 49-yard TD catch at Rutgers. 6'5" Michael Stapert made quite a first impression on Shore Sports Zone when he grabbed this 77-yard TD in St. John Vianney's season-opening win at home over Mattawan. The Lancer senior has earned a college offer from Central Connecticut State and should garner more college interest, as Stapert has shown the ability to be sure-handed and gain chunks of extra yardage after the catch. Stapert averaged over 30 yards a catch and finished his senior season with 10 TDs. Jadon Stevens represents the Asbury Park Blue Bishops on the All-Zone football team. Stevens fit the mold of big play receiver with 5 100-yard receiving games and 4 games with 2 or more touchdowns. When you add it all up, Stevens finished with 34 catches for 726 yards and 11 touchdowns. Brick Township's Jasir Taylor is one of the most diverse talents on our roster. Taylor did it all for the Green Dragons with over 1,000 all-purpose yards and 16 touchdowns. He was able to score on the ground, through the air, as well as 2 defensive scores and a punt return TD. Taylor will be one of the top returning players to the Shore Conference when he suits up for Brick Township in his senior year in 2016. These are your All-Zone tight ends. Nick Galante represents the Freehold Township Patriots. His coach, Corey Davies, says Nick is one of the best players he's coached in 27 years. He did it all for Freehold Township, handling the kicking and punting duties and delivering 6 sacks and 8 tackles for a loss from his defensive end slot. But we've got him at tight end, where he was one of Jack O'Brien's favorite targets with 43 catches for 690 yards and 9 trips to the paint. Shore Regional didn't throw the ball much, but when they did, Connor Rempel was there. Rempel had 6 catches for 137 yards and 3 touchdowns, and was also one of the ringleaders of a Shore Regional defense that gave up 7 points or less in 10 games on the way to a perfect 12-0 season. Rempel is also an outstanding student who is being recruited to play football at a number of Ivy League institutions. This is your All-Zone offensive line. Raritan's Bo Bentley brings beef to the SSZ offensive line. At 6'4", 285 pounds, Derek Ernst would be the first to endorse this earth mover, who helped set the tone for the Rockets' run game. From his left tackle position, Bentley was protecting quarterback Mark Carnaval, allowing him time to make throws. Bentley closes out his high school career as a Central Jersey Group 2 state champion. Micah Clark is back on the SSZ All-Zone team for a second straight year. The junior is one of the nation's top offensive linemen, with offers from nearly every major college football program. Clemson, Ohio State, Alabama, Michigan State, and Iowa are just a small part of the list of Division I offers. Clark is rated the top offensive lineman in New Jersey and the East region by Scout.com. And the good news for Lancers fans is he'll be back for one more season at St. John Vianney. Shore Regional head coach Mark Constantino gives a simple scouting report on Eric Graham. He dominates on both sides of the ball. Graham was a two-way lineman making big plays from defensive tackle, but we put him on the O-line, where he was a leader of a unit that helped the Blue Devils dominate on the ground. Graham and the Shore line made its most emphatic statement of the year when the Blue Devils rolled up over 500 yards on the ground in the state finals against Palmyra. Offensive linemen are tough customers, but Middletown South's Thomas Lopez takes it to another level. Lopez played his junior season with a torn labrum and fought through nagging injuries to become a standout at left tackle. The 6'5", 270-pounder is one of NJ.com's top 50 recruits in New Jersey and is gaining interest every day from Division I schools throughout the Northeast. Lacey's Joe McAvoy fits the bill for an All-Zone offensive lineman. At 6'3", 315 pounds, McAvoy has a nickname that works with his large frame, Joey Thick. McAvoy has offers from a number of schools, including Wagner, Monmouth, and Central Connecticut State. 6'3", 270-pound Pat McGowan was one of the leaders of the Middletown North offensive line. The Lions offense racked up nearly 3,000 yards, and head coach Steve Bush knows that it starts with the play in the trenches. McGowan was able to protect Donald Glenn and open the holes for Chad Freshnock and Connor Welsh. One of the big reasons that Brick Memorial scored a 9-win season and reached the Central Jersey Group 4 Finals is great two-way line play. We saw Anthony Nobile deliver some great individual efforts on the defensive side of the ball, but he was just as important on the offensive line, where he gave the Mustangs the openings that let them run wild on opposing defenses. Joe Rutkowski was the center on the Middletown South offensive line that opened the holes for Cole Rogers and James McCarthy. It was Rutkowski who helped set the pace for Middletown South's no-huddle attack and provided leadership to an Eagles team that captured a sectional title and finished ranked as the top team in the Garden State. Joe Selmayr makes his second appearance at the Shore Sports Zone All-Zone Football Banquet, and deservedly so. The leader of the Manalapan Braves offensive line, he has the respect of not only his coaches, but opposing coaches as well, earning a first-place vote in our Zoneman Trophy balloting. At 6'2", 280 pounds, Selmayr was a three-year starter who also contributed to the defensive line at Manalapan and has an offer from Bryant University in Rhode Island. Liam Smith was the anchor of the Red Bank Catholic offensive line. Head coach Jim Portella praises Liam and his ability to excel both in pass blocking and run blocking. And the Duke Blue Devils agree. Liam will sign a national letter of intent to play at the ACC school in Durham, North Carolina. The 6-foot, 285-pound senior will close out his high school career in California, playing in the Semper Fi All-American game. This is the All-Zone Defensive Line. Deshaun Cope set the tone on the Toms River North defense. Teams tried to double-team the Mariners senior, but he was still able to dominate. Nicknamed Day-Day, he's back at our banquet for a second straight year, with even more impressive numbers than his junior campaign. Cope's topped the 100-tackle mark and delivered 12 sacks, as well as 12 tackles for loss. Matt Dombrowski was able to make his presence known with 9 sacks, 14 tackles for loss, and 19 quarterback hurries. Dombrowski was a big reason that Middletown North had one of its best seasons in nearly two decades, highlighted by a home playoff win against Sayreville. Dombrowski finished his senior season with 64 tackles and 1 interception. Brick Township gives nicknames to its defensive players. Dan Finelli was Batman, and he was the Dark Knight of the Green Dragons defensive unit. Finelli had an incredible 31 tackles for loss to go along with 9 sacks and 76 tackles. The 6'1", 255-pound senior was a big reason why Brick Township had one of the best defenses in the state, pitching 5 shutouts. Brick Memorial's breakthrough season can be attributed to stellar play on the line, and Chris Hayes teaming up with the Nobile twins was a big reason that the Mustangs made it all the way to Rutgers and the state finals. Nicknamed Pep, he brought some serious pep with over 60 tackles and 9 sacks. 6'3", 230-pound Jordan Keefe was easy to spot on the Brick Township defense. He was Shore Sports Zone's version of Clay Matthews, and he had numbers like the Green Bay Packers great. Keefe delivered 17 sacks on the season to go along with 75 tackles, and he led the Green Dragons in quarterback hurries with 20. Keefe was one of the ringleaders on a defensive unit that had 4 consecutive shutouts, one of the bright spots of an 8-2 season at Brick Township. It's hard for linemen to get noticed, but Mike Nobile's dominant play on both sides of the ball for Brick Memorial gained the attention of Shore Conference coaches. Mike finished 6th in our Zoneman Trophy balloting, picking up a pair of first-place votes. He led the Mustangs with 15 tackles for loss and 4 fumble recoveries. Mike and his twin brother Anthony plan to play college football together. Shore Conference coaches will attest that whatever school gives them an opportunity is getting quite a package deal. Sean Naaman was one of the senior leaders on the Red Bank regional defense. Naaman led the Bucks with 8.5 sacks and 10.5 tackles for loss, and he was able to use his 6'3" frame to knock down 5 passes. With an 11-1 record and claiming a B-North crown, Red Bank Regional had one of the best seasons in school history, and Naaman now gets set to go to college where he wants to pursue a career in sports medicine. Riley Radosovic is the third Manalapan Brave to make our all-zone football squad. The 6'4", 260-pounder played tight end, but we like him on the defensive line, where he brings smarts on and off the field. Radosovic has offers from 2 Ivy League football programs in Princeton and Cornell, as well as an offer from Dayton University. Tyler Towns was a leader of the Jackson Memorial defensive line, and he led the short conference with an eye-popping 22 sacks, 66 tackles, and 21.5 tackles for loss. He also served as the Jaguars' tight end, catching 2 TDs. In the state finals against Brick Memorial, Towns delivered 2.5 sacks and was able to slow down an explosive Mustangs run game. These are your all-zone linebackers. Calvin Beattie is back for his second stint on the all-zone football team. The St. John Vianney linebacker finished his senior year topping the 80 tackle mark. At 6 feet, 225 pounds, Beattie has the combination of great athleticism and strength. He has a 33-inch vertical and squats 525. Beattie was also a great power back on the offensive side of the ball, scoring 3 times in his senior campaign. Doug Goldsmith was on plenty of Shore Sports Zone highlights as the bruising running back in Shore Regional's ground machine, but his play at linebacker can't be overlooked. Goldsmith rarely came off the field for Coach Mark Constantino. The Blue Devils leader anchored a defense that gave up just 7.66 points per game on the way to a perfect 12-0 season. He closed out his high school football career in grand style with 5 touchdowns against Palmyra. With a pair of state championship football rings, Goldsmith will play Division I lacrosse at the University of Albany. James McCarthy stepped in for an injured Cole Rogers and was an outstanding running back for the Middletown South Eagles, but his full-time role on the defense was even more impressive. McCarthy is the total package. He can pursue the quarterback and deliver a sack. He's got great lateral movement to stop big gains, and he's got great hands to make the interception. McCarthy finished with 16 touchdowns on offense and 3 interceptions on defense, the final pick coming at MetLife Stadium during the Eagles' 35-7 win over Phillipsburg to win the North 2 Group 4 title. Dylan Murphy spent plenty of time on the Shore Sports Zone highlight reel as a key cog in the Red Bank Catholic offense with 654 yards on the ground and 14 touchdowns. But he's even more impressive at linebacker. Murphy brought a physical presence to the RBC defense with 118 tackles and 2 sacks. Watching Red Bank Regional on defense, it was easy to spot who was around the ball. Chris Outerbridge brought the speed and strength, but it's his instincts that made him so dangerous. Outerbridge led the Bucks with 102 tackles. He made one of the biggest plays of the season with this 26-yard scoop and score to beat Ocean Township on the road. Head coach Nick Giglio will look to Outerbridge to be a leader when he returns in 2016 for his senior season in Little Silver. Cole Rogers may get all the headlines and highlights as the Middletown South running back, but twin brother Dylan Rogers is equally important on the defensive side of the ball. Dylan has a motor that simply wears out opposing offenses. When you watch film of the Eagles' defense, number 35 is around the football all the time. The Rogers twins were 3-year starters for Middletown South, winning 26 games in that span. Brian Batchelor says that Mike Ruane is one of the best defensive players he's ever coached, and the Rumson-Fairhaven linebacker has the numbers to back it up. Ruane finished with 153 tackles, ranking top 5 in the short conference, to go along with 4 sacks and 2 interceptions. Ruane had at least 9 tackles in every game he played on the way to RFH's 3rd consecutive Central Jersey Group 3 championship. Aleem Shaw closes out a tremendous career as one of the best defensive players in Mattawan Huskies history, and the numbers back up that claim. As a 3-year starter, Shaw had 596 tackles and 28 sacks. Shaw is having a great week, not only being named to the All-Zone team, but he announced that he'll be playing Division I college football at Sacred Heart in Connecticut. Introducing your All-Zone defensive backs. Donovan Catholic's David Calderon first caught our eye at Chris Melvin's elite recruit showcase in the summer, and that carried over to a successful senior season at Donovan Catholic. Calderon has great speed with a 4.45 time in the 40-yard dash and the ability to contribute on both sides of the ball. The senior was a big reason that the Griffins went from 0 wins last year to a 4-6 mark in 2015. Calderon has picked up multiple college offers and is expected to make his choice and sign in February on National Signing Day. Tom Coffey was a two-way contributor to the perfect season at Middletown South. With 6 touchdown catches, he was one of Matt Mascara's top targets and was equally impressive in the Eagles' secondary. Coffey had 5 interceptions, one of those a pick six, and he was able to break up passes all season long. Jake Curry took his game to another level in his senior year at Freehold Borough High School. Leading the Colonials' offense at quarterback, he was responsible for over 2,000 yards of total offense and 19 touchdowns. We saw a lot of Jake Curry TD passes and TD runs on our highlight show, but he was equally impressive on defense, where he had 109 tackles to go along with 6 interceptions, good for 2nd in the Shore Conference. Khalil Haskins is back at the Shore Sports Zone Banquet for a 2nd straight year. He was a defensive back in 2014, and we have him back in our secondary in 2015. But Haskins is a triple threat, with great play on special teams as a returner and as a dynamic receiver. On our highlight show, we've seen him make a number of big-time plays as a wideout. But lost in the great offensive play is his defensive abilities. He led the SJV secondary with 3 interceptions and has a Division I offer from the University of Utah. Middletown South's Max Imshow finished as the Shore Conference leader in interceptions with 7. With great pressure from the defensive front, Imshow was able to pick his spots and make big plays in the secondary. He found the paint thanks to this pick six at Freehold Township and delivered his 7th and final interception of the season on Thanksgiving Day against rival Middletown North. RJ Janicek is a playmaker. We discovered that in the summer when he helped Wall Township win the Monmouth County 7-on-7 tournament, and it carried over into the season. Janicek has great hands and the ability to make the spectacular play as well as the routine catch. On defense, he was one of the Shore Conference leaders with 5 interceptions, including this pick six against Long Branch. Sean Ramcharan was at our banquet last year, winning a Monmouth Building Center game ball for his performance in the state championship game. This year, Ramcharan has earned a spot in the All-Zone secondary. A great two-way player, Ramcharan had 30 catches for 538 yards and 5 TDs to go along with 4 picks on defense. Ramcharan will join Huskies teammate Aleem Shaw playing Division I football at Sacred Heart. Your All-Zone Kicking Squad. Matt Mascara is the All-Zone kicker for a 2nd straight year. We're more familiar with his role as the Eagles quarterback, and he put up some great numbers, topping 1,400 yards through the air. But once again, he was so consistent when kicking the football. Mascara was 59 of 61 on extra points and kicked 3 field goals, including a 47-yarder. Jack O'Connor had some incredible numbers as Red Bank Regionals kicker, leading the Shore Conference with 9 field goals. But we've got him as our All-Zone punter. On more than one occasion, O'Connor set up the Bucks defense to do great things by pinning the opponent inside the 5-yard line. He had a strong leg and the ability to deliver directional punts that helped RBR in the all-important battle of field position.
The first time we saw Christian Bujati on Shore Sports Zone, he made this interception against St. John Vianney's Anthony Brown, a highlight he plans to show his kids one day. A 3-year letter winner at Monmouth Regional, he was the Falcons' leading receiver with 21 catches for 255 yards. Those are some solid numbers, but they pale in comparison to these numbers. A 5.3 weighted GPA and a No. 2 class ranking. How does Christian manage an aggressive academic schedule and the responsibility of playing varsity football? One word sums it up.
The biggest word, focus. Like, there are 24 hours in a day, And, like, it was made for that for a reason. Like, you can do so much in 24 hours if you really just focus and put your mind to it and, like, get rid of the distractions, phone, TV, all that stuff. And I think when, like, there's a time and a place to do everything. So, like, if I'm working on homework, okay, work on homework, get it done efficiently, but also do a good job. And, like, at practice, like, if we're at practice, my mind's at practice, not on what I'm going to do after or what test I have the next day. Like, focus on practice. And that kind of keeps me grounded as to what I'm doing, like, day in and day out, and, like, what the future holds. So.
I'm a big believer of academics, and we push that here, and we're starting to improve it here. But he's a unique man that can do it right away. That helps our team because he becomes a great example.
Playing varsity football and a rigorous academic schedule does not tell the entire story. Christian was moved by the Don Cheadle movie Hotel Rwanda, and it inspired him to become an activist in human trafficking. Bujani formed a nonprofit group and the website areyouaware.net, where he has built a social media voice and information on this worldwide problem.
We led initiatives to donate soap bars to hotels, and the soap bars would be wrapped with the human trafficking awareness hotline on it. So when women, children are being trafficked, and a lot of times they're held in hotel bathrooms, they can take the hotline that's wrapped on the bar of soap and call at a time when they're away from the trafficker.
He has lofty goals and a clear path to them. Christian is hoping to attend Columbia University in New York, where he will major in human rights, and hopes one day to work for the United Nations to take the next step in the fight against human trafficking.
Human trafficking is one that it's modern day slavery, and it really takes part at like peak sports events like the Super Bowl, the Olympics, the World Cup. And so that kind of sector of the United Nations really gets to the root of the problem and kind of breaks down the barriers of like sport and human rights injustice, essentially. So that's where I kind of want to go.
To spend the time and yet be focused to play football, it takes a special person. And I really believe he's been a special person. And God bless him for what he does to help us in our world. I'm really very proud of him.
From the Falcons field to an elite college and one day the United Nations, Shore Sports Zone congratulates Christian Bujani, our 2015 Scholar Athlete of the Year.
Hey guys, I just want to first thank Rich Krampanis for, I'm really humbled for this award and honor. I didn't really think I was going to make a speech, I'm a little nervous, but I thank, first off, my mom and my dad for always supporting me through everything. My coaches for always, I said, keeping me sane through this whole process, because, I mean, I'd come to them, like, stressed out with, like, tests and stuff like that, but I'm just really happy, and I thank all you guys for coming, and thanks for the award.
Monmouth Building Center in Shrewsbury has been a cornerstone of the Jersey Shore since 1967. For the second straight year, their support of Shore Sports Zone has allowed us to hand out game balls every week during the 2015 high school football season. With the Shore Conference delivering six state titles, we close out this year's game balls by saluting six great performances from State Championship Saturday. The Jackson Memorial Jaguars made a magical run from a number 7 seed to a second straight Central Jersey Group 4 title. The Jags delivered a dominating performance at Rutgers in a 42-13 win over rival Brick Memorial. An unsung hero on the defensive side of the ball was Adante Davis. One of the senior leaders, Davis was tremendous in this matchup, delivering a sack and a fumble recovery in the victory. Toms River North delivered a hard-fought 14-7 win at Rowan against Williamstown to win the South Jersey Group 5 crown. Offensive lineman Luke Butera opened holes for Mike Husney and Asante Moore all year long. The Mariners game ball recipient is an unsung hero and a vocal leader of a championship team. The key to Rumson-Fairhaven winning three straight state titles is defense. Bulldog senior linebacker Max Frang had a tremendous performance in RFH's 21-0 win against Red Bank Regional. Frang had 10 tackles against the Bucks and finished his career with 245 career tackles. One of the best defensive performances in the entire state came at MetLife Stadium. Dylan Rogers was determined to get the Middletown South Eagles a state title, and he was relentless against Phillipsburg. Rogers delivered 4.5 sacks to close out his high school career as the Eagles claimed a 35-7 win over Phillipsburg to win the North 2 Group 4 state championship. The Shore Regional Blue Devils racked up over 500 yards on the ground at Kane University, and senior Jack Britton joined teammate Doug Goldsmith in topping 200 yards in the Group 1 state title game. Britton had 22 carries for 207 yards and a touchdown in the Blue Devils' 56-28 win over Palmyra. And the most dramatic moment of the state championships. 10 seconds left, Raritan trails 26-21. It's fourth down and the Rockets are down to their last chance. Quarterback Mark Carnival throws a bullet to Nick Pasquin, and the senior delivers a moment that will be talked about in Hazlitt for generations. Pasquin also had an interception for a score in the Rockets' 28-26 win to claim the Central Jersey Group 2 state championship. Shore Sports Zone and Monmouth Building Center congratulate our state championship game ball winners.
Hi, I'm Anthony Brown. I play quarterback at St. John Vianney.
1 year ago, Anthony Brown stood on our podium as one of the top players in the Jersey Shore. A lot has happened since he's last been on the Shore Sports Zone stage. It started with a commitment to Boston College and then reaching the prestigious level of the Elite 11 National Semifinals, recognized as one of the top 30 high school quarterbacks in America.
If you let the recruiting process take care of you, you're going to get big-headed, you're going to get cocky, you're going to get all this extra stuff, and it's going to usually lead to your downfall, as Shakespeare would put it, a tragic hero.
In the midst of his maturation on the field, Anthony Brown became a leader in more ways than one. With a sudden coaching change just prior to the 2015 season, it was Brown who connected with new head coach Derek Sininski and helped the entire Lancers team gel to become one of New Jersey's most dominant football teams.
Coach Sininski taught us faith at the beginning of the season when everything was going downhill. And I didn't say this in no other interviews, but that kind of changed the way I thought of things. Like, you have to have faith to become something you want to be. If you don't have faith in it, why try?
After all the, you know, the emotions and everything got through, I guess kind of through August, and not even really, you didn't see that special talent, even in our scrimmage games, you know. But right up until when we played Mattawan, that's when, you know, I kind of knew, wow, this kid's a, you know, he's a special kid.
The highlight reel could go on for hours, but it's real easy to find one play that shows why Anthony Brown is a special quarterback. It came on a rainy, windy night in Homedale against Rumson Fairhaven.
The ball got in my hands and all of a sudden it was dry. It was wet the play before, so I was kind of surprised as I was driving back feeling a dry football. And then the wind started to kick up again as I was dropping back. And I threw the ball. I didn't expect it to come out the way it did because of how rainy it was and the wind. And then when I looked up, I was like, oh my God. And then I saw Marquis caught the ball and just kept it moving. And it was great. I don't even know how to explain it. It was a good moment in that game.
Brown is saying goodbye to high school football quicker than most. He's set to enroll at Boston College in January to get a jump start on his college football career.
It's very bittersweet. I have to leave my friends. I have to leave everything back at home. People that I love, people that helped me get to where I'm at right now. And I can't continue what I want to continue in high school, but it's for a better future. Oh! 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 This is my team.
He's thanked his teammates and his coaches. There's just one more important duo that Anthony Brown wants to thank. His parents.
Without them, I wouldn't be the person I am today. I wouldn't be going to Boston College at all. I wouldn't be the football player I was if it wasn't for my dad bringing me to the fields at 6 o'clock in the morning every summer day and just working me and my mom staying on me on top of me for my homework so I have to get good grades, because without grades, you can't go to college for football, things you love. So I just want to thank you.
Hi, I'm Sadiq Palmer. I play wide receiver and safety at Red Bank Regional.
Sadiq Palmer was on top of the world. Following a stellar junior season, he gave a verbal commitment to play Division I football at Syracuse. With all the pressure of recruiting behind him, it should have been a summer of celebration and preparation for one more year of high school football. But all that changed on July 10th. Rasheem Palmer was shot and killed in Eatontown. Sadiq lost his father just 1 month before the start of football season. He lost weight as the tragedy took a physical and emotional toll. He found healing when he returned to his football family.
He was away from us for a while, and it took him a while. It took two, three, four, 5 weeks to get going again. And at the same time, he did. And as soon as which we thought was going to happen, once he joined us again and got around his teammates, and that really started to see a change back into something good again going on in his life.
It was the worst experience of my life, but it just motivated me to go harder and just be the best I could be at anything I do in life.
With a headband and a t-shirt to honor his memory, Palmer has done his dad proud. In the face of adversity, Palmer elevated his game to another level. Not only making catches while being double teamed, he was a running threat and a game changer on the defensive side of the ball.
They make me play harder because they're playing so hard. So, I mean, I gotta play harder to get some shine. So, I mean, that's why we're so good this year. Everybody wants it more than each other. So that just makes everybody on our team work even harder.
For 12 years, the Red Bank Regional Football Program did not experience a winning season. But Palmer and his fellow seniors brought the Bucks to new heights in 2015.
We've been playing since we were younger, most of us, so we all have a bond of playing with each other, and it just translated on to our senior year.
If there's one play to show the relentless determination of Sadiq Palmer, it came against the Homedale Hornets.
I remember it was a slant call. I caught the ball. I initially got hit, but I didn't go down, so then another guy hit me. I broke that tackle. Then the last guy just stiff-armed him, and it wasn't no telling me I wasn't getting into the end zone.
What he's done every year, every day really at practice, you want to say, amazes me. And we're very fortunate to have him. He's made our team better, our town better, our community better, myself better. And very fortunate to have him be a part of my life.
With a coaching change at Syracuse, there might be a change of college plans. But no matter where he goes, Sadiq Palmer is ready to fulfill the promise he made to himself and his pops.
My dad wanted me to be a great person and a great football player, so I made a promise to him that that's what I'll do. And from now on, that's what it's going to be.
Tyler Thompson, running back for Ocean Township.
The best place to start the Tyler Thompson story is at the 30-yard line at Spartan Stadium. After 3 years of accolades and attention from major colleges and media from across the state, everything came to a screeching halt at this spot on November 1st of 2014 as a broken leg against Red Bank Catholic ended Tyler Thompson's junior season.
I definitely remember my leg was just real hot. It was just burning. And I looked down at it, I picked up my leg like this, and this half of my leg, this is right where I broke it, and this half of my leg just dropped, just dangling, just like this. I remember looking to the sideline, and Coach Tomo was like, all the coaches were like, and everybody on the team was jumping up and down, like, oh my God, oh! I was thinking, like, the whole Kevin Ware injury. Thank God it didn't break the skin. But then I remember my mom coming on the field, and that just, I was looking back the whole time.
Inspired by the support of the entire Ocean Township football family, Thompson wasted little time to get back on the comeback trail. Still bedridden, he began doing pull-ups and push-ups in his room, determined to come back faster and stronger.
The team just helped me out a lot, like mind-wise, and they were just telling me, you know what, Ty, you're going to be even better than you were. We know how you are. We know how hard you work, and you're going to get it done.
And I was telling people going into it, you know, going into this season, that this is the biggest, fastest, strongest Tyler Thompson we've seen, and it proved to be true.
It didn't take long to realize that Tyler Thompson was back as he galloped for 187 yards and 3 touchdowns in the Spartans' opening win against Neptune. Thompson scored 21 touchdowns in his senior year, but his most memorable play was not a score. With the Spartans and Red Bank Catholic tied at 35, Thompson took a screen pass from Kenny Pickett and set the stage for one of the biggest wins in Ocean Township history.
As soon as I got the ball, I just saw green, and I was like, there's no way they just gave me all this green. So I started running, and I don't know who it was. Somebody grabbed my jersey and tried to tackle me like 10 yards before where I actually got tackled, and I was like, there's no way, get off me, and just kept running. It definitely, like, people were talking about it for 2 weeks after we beat them, and it was just a great feeling because we know Ocean Township has never beaten RBC. That was the best feeling of the season.
With 5,419 yards and 56 touchdowns, Tyler Thompson has set a standard for Ocean Township football. The only thing that matches his immense talent is his character. As he chases the dreams of major college football in the NFL, the bond between Tyler and the Spartans will remain strong.
I really don't believe that there's anywhere else like Ocean Township. You know, when I got hurt, literally the whole football team, all parents, some of the parents I didn't even recognize, would just come to my house and drop off pounds of food, not even know them. And they'd keep doing it throughout week, every day of the week. And I'm just so blessed to be around a great group of people.
Tyler is very loyal to me and to this football program. And he told me, you know, after his freshman year, I won't play for anybody but you. And that type of loyalty to me and to our program means everything. You know, and I say it all the time, God's blessed me with two beautiful daughters. I consider Tyler Thompson a son. I mean, this is a relationship that we have right now, and this will be something that, you know, that will grow as time goes on as well.
From St. John the Annie High School.
It means a lot because just knowing that I'm surrounded by so much talent around this area that no one seems to know about, and we're starting to get so much more recognition, it's honestly a blessing and an honor to win this award. It's an amazing way to wrap up my high school career because my sophomore year, I would have never thought I would be in this room, so it's great.
The amount of talent that's in this room is truly amazing in a short conference, and you don't get a chance to really experience that at a single game event like you do here. So, yeah, just a special night.
It's awesome because you really get to understand how much talent there really is in the short conference, and just being in a room with everyone just puts it all in place for us to just sit down and take a look at, and it's really unreal how much talent there is in the short conference.
It's such an honor. I mean, everyone here, it's the best players in the shore. I'm just honored to be a part of it, of course.
Unbelievable. It was a great, great time. Literally one of the best banquets I have been to, an award ceremony. And it was great seeing our kids and our seniors here tonight, being able to go off like this and be recognized by Rich.